Hello, my name is Tommy. In this video, I wanted to talk a little bit about minimalism and why I'm into it. If you've heard about minimalism, I'm sure you've probably already seen a couple of videos on YouTube. Minimalism is a very trendy topic. I just wanted to share why I use minimalism and what it is, a little bit about that. What I love the most about minimalism is the pure simplicity of it. You know, it's like when you don't have a mind that's filled with distractions, everything just becomes more enhanced. Imagine being on a beach and you have a lot on your mind. Your mind is basically cluttered with things that concern you, different problems, bills you have to pay, problems that you have to fix. And all of these things, they keep your mind so occupied that you can't enjoy the experience of being on the beach. The sounds, the fragrances of the ocean and the grass and the blue sky and the warmth of the sun on your skin. With minimalism, I feel that I've been able to enjoy life just a little more. I'll be completely honest, minimalism is definitely one of the most life-altering things I've tested. But I had to go against basically everything that society has taught me. Having a lot just doesn't make you happy. It's actually the opposite. The solution is less, not more. And so I'm on this journey to get rid of stuff. Don't get me wrong, I'm not one of those extreme minimalists. I'm not getting rid of everything, but I'm getting rid of a lot. The more I get rid of, the better I feel inside. The more I feel I can enjoy life and even the things that I really enjoy in life, things that I have on this table that I'm going to show you in a moment and talk about. But the goal of my minimalism, it's not to get to zero. That's not the goal. The goal is to find a balance of having just the right amount of stuff and just the right amount of distractions. Now, I would love to be distraction-free, but let's face it, life is filled with distractions. That's just a part of life. You have to deal with distractions. And in order to do that, I use these different tools. I use minimalism, I use meditation, I use essentialism. I try to be very mindful and intentional in the way I deal with a lot of things in my life. So first, I just want to give you a little bit of a backstory. I grew up basically very poor. It was just me and my mom. My mom worked as a kindergarten teacher, and we basically didn't have a lot of money. Now, I'm not going to complain. I basically had everything that I needed, but we did live on the bare minimum. And this lifestyle basically made me and my mom think that we needed more in order to be happy. It's quite logical if you think about it. If you have a little, you want a lot, or at least something. And in order to have more, you need money. And in order to have money, you need to be successful. And in order to be successful, I had to get an education. And I did. And I was very successful, and I did get a great job. Unfortunately, this is where my life started to develop into a lifestyle obsession of owning stuff. Now, I'll be honest, at first, it was a lot of fun. I got a lot of fancy toys to play with. But after a while, I do remember feeling this emptiness, you know. And a lot of minimalists, they'll tell you the exact same story. That what drove them into this life of minimalism is that they had a lot of stuff and life just started to feel emptier and emptier. And this is definitely my experience also. But it became like this cycle. I just started to buy stuff, but in order to buy stuff, I had to work. And there was this cycle, you know, you work, you pay your bills, you get stuff, and then you just repeat the same pattern. Your life becomes a routine, and basically you're just working to get stuff, and you need stuff to become happier, but they are also the root cause why you're not happy. So it's a real paradox, and you just have to break that cycle. So somehow. And for me, the thing that broke my cycle, it was minimalism. And I first heard about minimalism through a Netflix documentary made by Matt D'Avella, and it's about these two minimalists. They're actually called The Minimalists, and they also have their own YouTube channel, so I'm gonna link to their channel and also Matt D'Avella's channel because he's a really cool minimalist that I follow myself. In short, I'm just gonna say that minimalism for me, it's not a lifestyle. It's not a contest like trying to reach some kind of an extreme level of minimalism. That's really not what minimalism is for me. Minimalism for me is just a tool. It's just something that I use every once in a while to just look at my life and just get rid of everything that I don't need. For example, clothes, that's something that I try to minimize every once in a while. Sometimes I have a wardrobe that's just packed with clothes that I don't even use, that I don't even know that I have. And that's the time where I try to use minimalism to just basically get rid of a lot of things. It's a very fulfilling experience. It's sort of like, you know, when you have a messy house, and you clean it up, and you just feel good inside. It's the same thing with minimalism. You just feel better inside. It just feels good to get rid of a lot of stuff that you don't use, and you only have the stuff that you really need. And as I mentioned before, I follow a lot of YouTubers who share their experience with minimalism. Now, some of them are a bit extreme and they basically only own enough that fits a backpack. That's definitely not me. I like having a house. I like having stuff. And today I just wanted to share a bit of stuff that I really enjoy owning. And I think this is a good example of how I use minimalism. Okay. So first of all, I'm a huge fan of cameras, and this is my favorite camera, but it's not my only camera. I have several cameras. I have the camera that is shooting this video, and I also have like a GoPro. I have a compact hybrid camera, and I wanted to have just one camera for everything. But the truth is, there is basically no camera that is good enough that can replace all of my cameras. Every camera has a specific purpose. An action camera, I can't use it in low light, but in action situations, it's perfect. You can have it in a pocket. The best image quality I get from this camera, but I can't fit this inside my pocket, so I can't bring it everywhere. And that's why I like using a hybrid camera or a GoPro. But this is still my favorite camera. And if I was to get rid of all but one, I would keep this one. And I wanted to talk a little bit about these things. I got the Apple AirPods, and I really like having the Apple AirPods, but they are not noise canceling, and I really like noise canceling, so I have these noise canceling headphones. I know there is a new version of AirPods that has noise canceling, but I just don't think it's as good as these ones. So I get a lot of value from these, and I get a lot of values from these. Now, a true extreme minimalist would say, oh, you only need one pair, and I just disagree with that. I don't need two pairs, but I prefer owning two pairs for different purposes. These are just tools that help me get the most out of my life. This one I hook up to my computer or my smartphone. This one I use on the train or on the bus or whenever I'm flying. It's perfect for that. This is my MacBook Pro, and I use this every day, but I don't use it for editing videos because I really enjoy editing videos on a big screen, and I have a computer up in my studio where I edit my videos. Now, I could make videos on my MacBook Pro. It would be a bit slower, a bit clunkier, but I absolutely could. That's not the point. Point is, I use this computer for browsing the web, and I use a desktop computer to edit videos. Oh, and then we have the Nintendo Switch. Now, I'm almost 40 and I still play video games. For the last 6 or 7 years, I've been sort of trying to quit playing video games because I'm sort of thinking, you know, I'm too old to play video games. This is ridiculous. I should be out there doing, you know, things in real life. But the truth is, I get a lot of satisfaction from playing video games, and I don't think I should cut myself out of it. Some would say that I'm wasting time playing video games, but using minimalism, I understand that I should cut back on things that I don't enjoy doing to have more time to play video games. Again, minimalism is the tool that helps me see what I prefer and enjoy to do. Finally, the smartphone. Now, we all have smartphones, so I'm just gonna say that this thing is wonderful and terrible at the same time. I think you probably know what I'm talking about. It's extremely addictive and it consumes a lot of time. Now, I've read Cal Newport's Digital Minimalism and I understand the dangers of social media. But for me personally, I think that, you know, in social media, it's just a reflection of life itself. You will find what you are looking for. So as long as you use your smartphone in an intentional way, using tools like minimalism and essentialism, I think you will be just fine. There are certain apps that I try not to use on my smartphone, like Instagram. I use it from time to time, but when I feel I become too addicted to it, I just remove the app, no problem. I'm gonna make a separate video about how I use my smartphone. It's gonna be more of a digital minimalism type of video. But for now, I'm just gonna say that I really enjoy using my smartphone, as I'm sure you do. Maybe you're even watching this video on your smartphone. I use this thing for so many things. I could make like a 2-hour video talking about how much I use my smartphone for different things. As I grew up without a smartphone, I can tell you that I appreciate a lot of things about the smartphone that I probably wouldn't have unless I had lived most of my life without a smartphone, if that makes sense. For instance, I love the fact that you can shoot videos and upload them to the internet and share with the entire world. I love the fact that you can live stream. I love the fact that you can compose music, art, digital art. I love the fact that you can make your taxes on your smartphone. You can pay your bills. You can find stuff. You have all sorts of information. Basically, you've got the entire collected wisdom of the human race in your pocket because of this device. And I appreciate that. But I will admit it is very addictive. So I try to use it in a very intentional way. It's not easy, but it's manageable. Now, I know that there are people who watch this video and say, you are not a true minimalist. But for me, it's like, you use minimalism as a tool in whatever area that you think you need it. I use minimalism, for instance, in my wardrobe. I use minimalism in my shed. I use minimalism in the fridge. I use minimalism even in my tech stuff when I feel I have too much, when I have too much cables, too many cameras. And this helps me appreciate what I really like in life. But I think in essence, what minimalism has taught me the most is that most of these things that you sort of feel like you love, these things are basically just tools. And that's what I use them for. And they help me to get the most out of life. But these are not the things that I want in life. The things that I want in life are things like, you know, enjoying a nice walk on the beach, spending time with my wife, spending time with my cats. And these things help me do those things. Now, as I mentioned before, I really enjoy playing video games. It calms me down after a stressful day at work. And I really enjoy making videos and taking pictures with my camera or my smartphone. It's a way for me to enjoy life. My experience with minimalism has been really, really good, even though I'm not one of those extreme minimalists. I think of minimalism as a way to detox your life from an old way of thinking. I see minimalism as a tool where you use it where you think it fits, you know? And I don't think that minimalism is about following rules. It's very open. It's mostly about just capturing the essence of life. And the essence of life is very different from person to person. Whatever a person needs, like, for me, it's cameras. For another person, it might be horses, you know. So we all have very different life purposes, but it is up to each and every one of us to find what that purpose is. And basically, I just feel like minimalism is the tool that helps you get that job done. For me, and you know, it's not just cameras. That's like just one of the things that I enjoy. For the main thing for me is and has always been to be with my family. Now, I think that a lot of people, if they really, really think about it, they can relate to that. We are social creatures. We need the company of each other. Loneliness is not the solution. We basically need to share life. And right now, the best way for me to reach the goal of spending as much time with my family as possible is to get rid of all distractions. And getting rid of distractions means that you're also consuming less. And when you're consuming less, you don't have to work as much. And so you can spend even more time with your family. See, there's really a lot of benefits with that. Okay, so that's it. That's all I had for today. I hope you enjoyed my little story about minimalism and how I use it. If you have any questions, just put them in the comment section below. I would love to know what you think about minimalism and if you use it. And I'm also on Instagram, I'm on Patreon, and that's pretty much it. Take care.